So I'm sitting there and doing all this running my data, and I'm like all excited because I find that students' perceptions of their support from family and friends, the more that students perceive that they have support from family and friends, the higher their sense of belonging, right? And I'm just like there running my data, and I find that it's significant. I'm like, oh my gosh, this is significant. And I tell my husband, and he was just like, well, duh. Because of course, if somebody feels that they've got friends and family that support their education, they're going to feel like they deserve and they want to go to college. And I was like, yeah, you're right. So I was just in the zone of like running numbers and data. But I think when he said that, it also opened up my perceptions. Like, we can get so caught up in just numbers and data that we forget about, you know, the human aspect and of what we know in general about just human nature and wanting to belong and to connect with people. So faculty student engagement. So the more that students engage with their faculty members, right? And again, this is kind of like one of those, like, obviously, one of those moments for me. So interestingly, I ran both in-class and out-of-class peer interactions, and the only one that was significant was in-class peer interactions. So I think this kind of also highlighted the importance of those interactions that occur within the classroom, because typically if we're talking about Latino men, you know, we know that they might not be hanging around campus after their classes. They might just leave. So those moments that we have them inside the classroom are so critical, because those are the times that that might be the only time that they ever engage with anybody else at that campus, with their peers there, or with the faculty. And so thinking about how do we utilize ways, or thinking about teaching strategies and techniques to engage our men in the classroom. Oh man, I'm talking a lot. Okay, I wanna get you to your case studies. You know, and also interactions with diverse peers was important. So it's feeling that they were interacting with not just Latino students, but other students. I think what was interesting was that the block that came out with the most number of significant factors was the block that focused on institutional level perception. So these were students' perceptions of the campus providing opportunities to engage with diverse peers, providing social support, providing support to succeed, providing financial aid. The more that a student felt that their campus did this for them, the higher their sense of belonging. So I think it just kind of echoed the role of the institution in providing that space for students to feel like they belong, to feel that they were being supported, to feel that they had opportunities to engage and with their peers. So clearly, as I mentioned, there's so many implications for research. I feel like we've scratched the surface of research on Latino men in community colleges. I think we're still underwater. But I think, you know, as we move forward and thinking about how do we continue to do research on Latino men, I think what this study itself lacks is that it doesn't disaggregate Latino, you know, Latino data. It kind of just groups everyone into together. When we know that the experiences of Salvadorian students are different than those from Mexico or those that are coming from Puerto Rico. Right, and so I think there's just different cultural nuances that could have an influence on the way that students experience their campus. The other thing is, you know, consider institutional level characteristics. So I know that this study kind of focused on the student, right? And we know that faculty-student engagement is important, but we don't know what that faculty demographic looks like. We don't know if students feel more comfortable or are more successful or feel a higher sense of belonging when they're dealing with faculty who are full-time versus part-time. I can tell you that through our qualitative data that we've been collecting, students who feel that they have less of a connection with their faculty, it's usually a part-time faculty because they don't have office hours. They don't even have an office for them to go to. And they're usually kind of running between campus to campus because they're doing their freeway flying. And it's hard for students and for the faculty themselves to feel that, you know, hey, well, the campus isn't really, you know, I'm just here to teach a class. You know, the campus isn't investing in me even as a part-time faculty to give me a space to meet with students. And so that came up in interviews and focus groups with students themselves, saying that, you know, they had a lot of classes with part-time faculty that they didn't connect with. You know, as I mentioned, the quantitative methods tell us what but not why. So I think we also need to continue exploring data and research on Latino men through a qualitative lens. Examining other outcomes. I mean, there's so many outcomes yet that we have to explore. You know, persistence, graduation, exploring the multiple I think a multifaceted identity as a Latino man. So I know that there were some comments up here about exploring, I don't know if it meant trans students as like gender by student sexuality and even gender identity, but I think that's something that I've been considering of exploring is like, well, we tend to clump all Latino males together, but we tend to forget those the intersections of their identity. So how might the experiences of a gay Latino male differ from a straight Latino male? That's something that I'm considering as well. And then as I mentioned, I think, you know, for me as a woman doing research on men of color and Latino men, I think it's also important to explore the role of women on the success and the lives of Latino men, because I know that during our interviews and our focus groups, time and time again, we hear when we ask students, you know, who's been supportive of you? Many times it's a female faculty. Many times it's a female counselor, or their mother, or girlfriend, or you know, a teacher from their high school. So I think there is something to say about the role of women, and kind of the gender, you know, this idea that women are assumed to be more open and sensitive and caring. And I think that's important that, you know, we think about how women can be support, you know, I mean, we're doing the work anyway, but I think because we do men of color work, we tend to think that it's only men of color doing the research or doing the work, when in fact we should be acknowledging the role that both men and women should be playing in being nurturing and being supportive and being caring, not just expecting that because you're a woman that, well, let me send that student to you because you're more caring. And you might be able to get to that student on a more emotional side. So I think just thinking about how we can leverage our women, the women at our institutions, and then, you know, all these implications for practice. So I think I mentioned yesterday in one of our panels that it's people. You know, at the end of the day, we talk about sense of belonging. We're talking about student engagement and feeling like they want to be at our institutions. We talk about that it's people, not programs, that make the difference. You know, I mean, yes, there's programs, but it's the people who support these programs. It's the people, it's the faculty, it's the staff, it's the administrators that are engaged in these programs that are what students relate to. And so, you know, I think these are just things that Luke was saying, you know, like learn students' names, but not just their names, but their daily lives. You know, and during focus groups interviews, students who said, you know, like, I was so surprised. I was walking through the halls and my professor remembered my name and they said hi to me. And for them, that was just so powerful because it meant that they cared. It meant that that professor cared enough about that student that they even remembered their name, that they weren't just a number. So I think, you know, I also talked about yesterday about being proactive, right? So I think with one thing, knowing Latino men and knowing that there's this, you know, maybe resistance to kind of not wanting to seek help because you don't want to look like you don't know what you're doing. I think it's important that we be more proactive. You know, invite students to come to office hours or maybe to coffee. I think for administrators, they talked about, you know, being more visible on campus. I think somebody mentioned it yesterday on the panel, right? So walk around the campus. Let students know who you are. And also, you know, as I mentioned, asking students about their lives off campus and getting to know them personally.